m'appelle Susanna Hoffs. Regardez-moi sur Rapido. Hi, I'm Susanna Hoffs, and you're watching Rapido.
Heaven loves ya. The clouds smile for ya. Nothing stands in your way when you're a boy. Clothes always fit ya.
Le premier album solo de Susanna Hoffs s'appelle When You're a Boy, quand tu es un garçon. Elle fait d'ailleurs une reprise de Boys Are Swinging de Bowie. C'est rigolo, non, comme titre pour une fille, je veux dire.
I still have a sense of humor about the relationships between men and women and, you know, there's a little bit of self-parody in it. There's also a little bit of feminism in it because it's all the lyrics are sung with like a sense of irony and like facetiousness, you know. It's like I'm not buying any of the things I'm saying. I'm almost like making a joke out of it. So it had a lot of different elements to it, and even though it is kind of an odd cover choice coming from my background, it was a chance to do something fun and different.
I've been dreaming since I was born.
My Side of the Bed se passe dans une chambre et avec un peu de chair nue, mais rien de comparable au Justify My Love de Madonna et Mondino. Pourtant, si on en croit Susanna, l'atmosphère du tournage était très chaude.
They said, we're just gonna do a handheld shot. This looks so great. The lighting is so wonderful. Just do whatever. Run around the room and this cameraman will follow you. So I just, it was like a great moment for me because I just thought, there's a room full of people staring at me, but I'm just going to have the time of my life and let go and think about the music and the words and just not worry for a second when anyone thinks of me. And it was great. I let go.
À Rapido, on a toujours suivi de près la carrière des Bangles, nous tapant même le bateau mouche à Amsterdam pour le plaisir de les filmer. Juste après, elles avaient eu un méga tube avec Eternal Flame et puis Susanna décida de se casser.
I think when you take on the job of doing the whole album after having been in a situation with four singer-songwriters where you have like three or four songs per album, you know, it was kind of a big undertaking, and I knew that it was also a great opportunity and a really fun opportunity to try things and try a broad range of things. And I didn't have a lot of ideas going in except to let it evolve naturally. But I did have a feeling inside that I wanted to be able to push the boundaries a little bit.
En 86, les rumeurs avaient couru bon train lorsque Prince avait écrit Manic Monday pour Susanna Hoffs. Mais s'était-il vraiment passé quelque chose entre Susanna et lui, hein?
They were all unfounded. I mean, I think Prince was interested in a way in me and the band and all, but I always kept a distance from him, and that's not hard to do because he's a mysterious person who keeps his distance from everybody, you know. So, but I always I found it real inspiring, and it was a really validating thing for us at the time, for the group and for me personally, to have this incredible artist take such an interest in us.
Au moment où les gogos se reforment, les Bangles se séparent. C'est si dur que ça de s'entendre entre bonzes.
Towards the end of the Bangles, it became, everyone was fiercely coveting their like vision, what they wanted to do, and everyone was very territorial about their songs. You know, it's like it became more and more like four separate bands within the same band, or four separate solo acts within the same band, and it made it, I mean, it was interesting doing that, but it became less of a group thing.